Hello, I'm Juni from MSK MRI.
Today's topic is normal ACL on coronal images. This is a crucial aspect of ACL anatomy, so please pay close attention. Assessing the ACL in the coronal plane is more accurate than using the sagittal plane as the primary diagnostic plane of the section. The red represents the anteromedial bundle of the ACL, and the blue represents the posterolateral bundle. The anteromedial bundle of the ACL has a distinctive convex, comma-shaped appearance at the tibial insertion. This comma shape encompasses the posterolateral bundle's anterior, more convex contour. In the anterior coronal image, the anterior horn of the lateral meniscus and the anteromedial bundle are visible. There is a fibrous connection between the anteromedial bundle and the anterior horn of the lateral meniscus. A slightly posterior coronal image shows the posterior aspect of the anterior horn aligning with the center of the posterolateral bundle. Therefore, from medial to lateral, the anteromedial bundle, posterolateral bundle, and anterior horn of the lateral meniscus become visible. The anterior root of the lateral meniscus consists of three or more multiple fiber bundles and is fan-shaped. This fissured appearance on MRI is due to fibrofatty tissue interposed between the insertional collagenous fibers of the anterior root and interposed fibers of the ACL insertion. Let's look at a more posterior coronal image. The posterior root of the lateral meniscus mainly attaches to the intertubercular area, with a thin, long ventral extension reaching just posteromedial to the tibial attachment of the ACL. Thus, the fibrous attachment between the posterior root of the lateral meniscus and the posterolateral bundle of the ACL is clearly visible due to their close proximity. The anteromedial bundle fibers originate from the anterior and proximal aspect of the femoral insertion, while the posterolateral bundle fibers originate from the posterolateral aspect. Therefore, the proximal anteromedial and distal posterolateral bundles are visible on the coronal image. Further posterior coronal images, especially at the MCL level and beyond, are important for evaluating the ACL because the proximal half of the anteromedial and the posterolateral bundle show a hypointense signal in the coronal plane. It is considered abnormal if the proximal ACL shows intermediate signal intensity on the proton density image or high signal intensity on fat-suppressed proton density. Normal ACL should also be visualized on at least one coronal image posterior to this level. If the ACL is not visible posterior to the MCL level, it suggests the possibility of a tear in the femoral attachment of the ACL. In addition, there should be no fluid signal intensity between the femoral attachment site and the ACL fibers. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please hit the like button.